10 years ago, John Armstrong met Anne, and it was an instant attraction. Joining forces in marriage and business, they set out to become multi-millionaires. Together, they've built UFIT, Coventry's third largest double glazing company. But with sales figures now on the slide, Anne's looking for some new ideas to revitalize the business.
It's a book called Success Through a Positive Mental Attitude. It's all about changing from a negative to a positive way of thinking. This is quite relevant because I've always been one of these people who has come in and gone, thou shalt not do this, thou shalt not do that, and I don't think it's always paid us dividends, has it? The crux of it is they either do it our way or they don't do it at all. Eating at desks. I'm really annoyed that I've actually put here that as recently as Monday this week, somebody was eating an apple at their desk. Look, down the centre here, there's cups all down the middle, there's cups on everybody's desk at the end of the day. And to be perfectly honest, I do think it's becoming a bit like a shithole. I know it sounds like we're being overbearing, and we're not asking you to walk over hot coals or anything, we're just saying we've got these policies to keep the place nice and tidy. So just adhere to them or go and work somewhere else, basically. My natural instinct is actually to be very, very nice and to, you know, isn't it?
Mm.
What I normally do every morning is just log on to the cameras. I love these cameras. This is the yard entrance. Lighting up in the yard. Smoking on this site is actually an act of gross misconduct and is sackable. And I am trying to do things differently, and it's as hard for me as it is for other people, I suppose.
You know you've made it when you've got your own blimp, don't you? Now we not only occupy the land, Anne, we're now master of the air.
What's been concerning Anne is how hard it is to get the sales force to actually use the phones.
Let's get this show on the road.
She and John spend £2,000 a week generating leads for the team, who sometimes spend as little as half an hour a day making calls. Anne intends to change all that.
I'm telling you something, from tomorrow onwards, all of those leads are going to be phoned. And what I'm saying to everybody now is that we've got to get these sales built up, because otherwise we're going to be in trouble. I want it to work, because he is going to shit on my head from a great height if it doesn't.
You don't want to be having a Ferrari and only driving it down the shops in first gear, do you? You know, that's like a bit like our business. We want to be getting it up into fifth gear and sixth gear. You know, want to be redlining it.
Don't want you to poo your pants over this, because I know I've not been brilliant in the past in terms of managing, basically. I react emotionally. So I'm going to try a new tact. Today is the end of whatever's happened before.
Anne isn't sure that she can bring about an improvement in the sales team's performance on her own.
Lovely Coventry skyline over there.
So she's invited a dynamic young business consultant to pitch for the job of helping her. But John is less than enthusiastic.
You're excited? This is going to be the start of something big today, John. Did you know that?
Mm-hmm.
You don't normally like consultants, do you, John?
No.
You normally think that you know better than they do, don't you?
No. Well, yeah, that's right, because if they're so fucking good, how come they ain't doing it then?
We really need to get an idea on why people are and why people aren't buying from you.
I can't bear to think that people are laughing at us because they've gone on the website, we've put shitloads of money into getting these leads, and they're going cold. Mm. We've tried the carrot, we've tried the stick, we've tried chocolate bars, we've tried everything. You know, we've got to do it a different way, and I'm excited about this.
Okay then. And how much is it?
Well, the way that it works is it's very, very simple. I charge myself at a direct 500, which is a very competitive rate.
But if we said we want what would be the sixth,
we can do it ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And
so are you going to increase the call rate then?
Well, the thing is, it's a number of things we'll do, and one of the things will be increasing the call rate.
There you are. So if we increase our call rate, we've done what you've done without having to pay you. What was, and now what is, and is to tomorrow a new day? Yes, it is.
Okay, that doesn't make any sense to me.
You're trying to put the tyre on the rim, and we ain't even got the spokes in yet.
If we're going to stop at the roadside and we're going to be putting a wheel back on, we might as well get onto a completely different road and go for it.
Yeah, but Anne, what I'm saying is that before you can go down that road, you've got to make sure the vehicle's got oil and water in, right? That we can do that. We don't need someone to come and do it for us.
But you need to then to bring the mat to the new road.
What I'm saying is, we can put our own wheel back on.
Okay.
We can do it ourselves.
All right, well, we'll do it ourselves.
Because basically, he's going to come here, charge you £5,500 to tell you that the bucket's got holes in it and that's why it's got a leak.
Shot down by John on the hiring of a consultant, Anne's next line of attack is to recruit a super salesperson.
I've just had an idea.
Oh.
I think we need to look for something a little bit different. We're looking for something special. We're looking for that certain something.
Mm.
And I'm a great believer in you can't tell how somebody's going to turn out. You can sit and talk to them until the cows come home, but, you know, I want to look at their personality and see what's behind the CV. So, anyway, that's my theory. Because we are a dynamic, growing company. I mean, let's be honest, we're not exactly stuck in the dark ages. And I want some people with a bit of go about them.
Anne's advertisement in the Coventry Evening Telegraph has produced just one applicant, 34-year-old Michael Handel.
I think he'd do quite well, personally. I think he'd fit in here quite well.
I think so as well.
I mean, the advert costs £120 and he's the only fucker who's sat in that chair. So he's got to fucking do it, right? And you will do it, won't you? Because, you know, he seems... I'm telling you, all the waifs and strays from all walks of life end up in double glazing. You'd be all right, fucking hell. I mean, see some of the people who've come here. You know, they've fucking managed.
This is our sales office. What we've got in here is our two lovely sales guys that are working down the bottom.
Right.
Good. Might have ironed his shirt before he come on.
And it's Neil.
He'd probably be just like the rest of them. He won't be here long. I'll give him about a week.
On a roll after recruiting Michael, Anne's convinced John to consider another consultant to help her motivate the team.
Got a meeting with, I don't know what to call him. He's been sold to me as a motivational type guy. We had somebody in to do some product training for us the other day, and although he admitted that our sales guys were a little bit brighter than they had been the previous time, he still thought that a couple of them probably weren't breathing at one point in the meeting. They were just very flat. It's just trying to keep them up. And we're sort of running out of ideas. So we've got to look at other ways now of getting around this, you know, keeping them motivated. So this guy said, look, I can put you in touch with Basil and he'll come along and have a talk to you.
It's a bit like, you ever seen Braveheart at the beginning? And he goes, you can fight for your family, you can fight your friends, but they can't take away your freedom. The principle's the same, isn't it? Well, he motivated them, didn't he? Time-honoured, tested, let's see how much he is like Mel Gibson.
The man pitching for the task of motivating the UFIT sales team is Zimbabwean motivational guru Basil Meany.
You seem to think you have a bit of a problem.
I think I don't have a problem, my salespeople do. Yeah. It just seems that they're a bit flat sometimes.
And I don't care what anybody says, attitude is everything. Mm. If you've got the right attitude, there is nothing you can't achieve. A one-arm golfer with the right attitude is far better than any two-arm golfer with the wrong attitude.
And your attitude determines your altitude.
Right, there you've got it.
If we notice up front that any of them are not going to use this program the way it should be used, or they're not really going to put a lot of effort into it, we'll tell you, don't, you know, you're wasting your time here.
We never have a failure with our programs. We don't have disappointed customers. So when you look at it, what do you actually get for your program?
Okay.
It's written as well as recorded material. You then get a plan of action, which is something that you will use for the rest of your life.
Basil's solution to the UFIT sales problem is to put all four team members on his infallible program, as well as John and Anne.
Okay. And how much is it?
It's £2,500.
£2,500.
Are you worth more than £2,500 as an individual?
£2,500 per person?
Yes.
Right. What sort of financial price can you do for us?
£2,500.
See, I can't buy something at the first price that someone says. That is not me.
You pay for what you get today.
Yeah, but we want to buy a rump steak for the price of half a pound of mince.
That's right.
You see? And that's the way this business works.
There's a whole pile of testimonial evidence there.
From solicitors from all sorts that you can... And we would encourage you to phone them. Speak to them.
Hello there. Could I speak to Peter Savage, please? What sort of deal did he do then?
Recorded on the CD.
Price-wise.
If we did anything at all, we would want husband and wife. Obviously, you would end up with one program.
We're not asking you to pay the whole lot up front either.
Okay. Let's say we have it at 2.5 over 6 months. Yeah. What about if we put two others through on it?
From a starting price of £15,000, John's managed to wear Basil down to providing an alternative package for the sales team for under £3,000.
That's the deal.
Okay.
Fine. I wonder if we could get a grant for it.
Next Tuesday, 2:30.
That's fine.
They're very excited about it. Can't wait to get hold of them.
They haven't met them yet, but they sense that there's young minds down there that need
that. Old boy was very G'd up about that, wasn't he?
At the end of the day, it can't do any harm. It really can't do any harm. And if we can just get a bit of life into the people. Right. To hear does not necessarily imply attention or application. To listen always does. Throughout Success Through Positive Mental Attitude, we urge you to listen to the message. This means to see how you can relate and assimilate the principle into your own life. What have I been saying over the last couple of days? People have got to listen. The hardest thing will be the day when I come in the mother of all moods. I'll say, that's it. Knew it wouldn't last long. They're probably just waiting for me to turn back into this moaning, whinging, evil woman who was here before. But the test will be the first day everything goes wrong.
It's not long before Anne's new positive thinking is put to the test. The cleaners haven't turned up for work.
We need an Uber, really. Well, no, I'll rephrase that. We've got an Uber. We need some cunt to push it up and down the carpet.
Why do people become cleaners if they don't want to do the cleaning? Now, my reaction was, I said to John, if they are complaining about the toilets,